students, today we will start with the chapter for class 8 mathematics, chapter 12 fundamental concept and operations on algebraic expressions. Now first of all, what is algebraic expression? That means it is the algebraic terms which will be combined by the notation, that is plus, minus, multiplication and division, and there will be two terms, constant and variable. So one term is constant because it is a numerical value, so it cannot be changed, so it is a constant. The other one is a variable because it can be changed. You can take the values of x as a, say 1, 2, minus 2, minus 3 and so on. Now next, there are the different types of polynomial or algebraic expression. First one is monomial, that means there will be only one term. So here I have taken the one example, that is 5x. Binomial, that is there will be two terms, that is 5x and one more term I have taken, that is 4y. So there are two terms, so that's why it is a binomial. And the third one is trinomial, there are three terms, so it is trinomial. Now next, let's go for the term, that is polynomial. What is the meaning of the term polynomial? Now in a polynomial, in that algebraic expression, the power of x will be as a positive integer, it cannot be negative one. So in the first case, the power of x is 2, x equal to 2, that is x square, so power of x is 2, so it is a polynomial. In the second case, if we see the power of x is minus 2, power of x is minus 2, so in this case, it cannot be a polynomial. First one is a polynomial, but in the second case, it cannot be a polynomial. So I think you can understand the what is the difference between the algebraic expressions and the polynomial. Then degree of polynomial, that means it is the highest power of that algebraic expression or polynomial. Now here the power of the highest below the power of x is 3. So degree of the polynomial is 3. Now let's go for this numerical that is given in the exercise. The next is 12a. We start with the numericals. Exercise 12a, question number 1. So let me take this numeric, that is 7x into y square into z cube. Now this is a only one term. So it is a monomial. Okay, then let's take Roman number 4, 2x plus 5. Now there are two terms, so it will be binomial. Then let's take another one, Roman number 6, xy plus yz plus zx. So in this case, if you see, there are three terms, it will be trinomial. I think it's clear to you. Now next, let's go for question number 2. Question number 2, say Roman number 3. The question is given here, minus 3 by 8 BCX. In this case, you have to find out the what is numerical value and the literal coefficient. Now in this case, numerical value is minus 3 by 8 and coefficient. Coefficients are, that is b, c, x. So these are the coefficients from this expression. I think it's clear to you. Then let's go for question number 3. Question number 3. The question is minus 3 by 5, the expression given x cube, then y square, then z. Now We need to find out write down the coefficient of Roman number 1 x square. We need to find out the coefficient of x square. Now to find out the coefficient of x square, you have to divide the given expression with x square. So therefore minus 3 by 5 x cube y square z by x square. Now what we get, if you divide minus 3 by 5 will be as it is, x square x cube by x square, that is x will be remaining, and y square z. So that is the coefficient of x square. Then let's find out for Roman number 3 also. That is 3 by 5 x, y, z. What will be the coefficient of this one? Now if you take this, the expression 3 by minus 3 by 5 x cube y square z by 3 by 5 x, y, z. Now 3 by 5 will be cancelled, then minus sign will be there. X cube by x, that is x square, y square by y, that is y, z and z will be cancelled, that is will be only minus x square y. I think you could understood what is the coefficients of the all this, that is x square and 3 by 5 x, y, z from the given algebraic expression. Next is question number 4. Let's go for question number 4. Identify the right terms, means you have to see which is the similar one. Let's do Roman number 1, x by 2 minus x by 3. Then you have to see whether this is a like terms or not. So this is a like terms. Like terms, because there is x variable is same, but constant is different, but this is the same algebraic expression, similar. So it's a like terms. Then let's take another one, Roman number 3, 6pq, comma minus 3px. Now in this case, p in the first case, but in the second case, this is x. Q is same in the first case and the second case. So it is different. It is not, variables are not same. So it is not like terms. Not like terms. So you can understand, I think, which are the like terms and unlike terms. Next, we will identify which are the polynomials from question number 5. Numeric was given in the question number 5. Question number 5. You would take Roman number 2, 3 plus y plus y square. Now if you see the power of y, in the first case this is 1, the second case it is 2. So this is a polynomial, because the power is positive integer. Now next, we take another example. Say Roman number 10, 5x square plus 6xy minus 7 root over y. Now in this case, if you see 5x square plus 6xy minus 7y to the power 1 by 2. Now in the, for the third term, the power of y is 1 by 2. So it is not a positive integer, it is a fraction. So it is not a polynomial. So I think you can understand which is a polynomial and which is not a polynomial. So you can understand in the first case all the power is positive integers. In the second case, that in the third term the power is a fraction, so it is not a polynomial. Next, we will go for question number 6. We have to find out the degree of polynomial. Find out degree of polynomial. Question number 6. Let's take Roman number 5. 1 minus x plus actual power 4 minus 3x squared. So degree of polynomial means it is the highest power of that polynomial. So what is the highest power? Highest power of x equal to 4. So therefore, degree equal to 4. Degree of this polynomial is 4. So I think you can understand how to find out the degree of polynomial from the given expression. Let's take Roman number 10. 5. So there is only one constant, but there is no variable. But how you can write down 5 into 1, because 1 also is a factor of every number. So 5, you can take any variable, say x, and the power is here 0. So in this case, the degree of this polynomial will be 0. So this you can identify the what is the degree of the polynomial. So this is question number 6. Similar way, we go for question number 7. You have to find out the what is the degree of polynomial. Okay, we will take Roman number 3. 2xy plus 3xy square plus 5x square y plus 7x square y square.